Amid the blues and greens of our Earth, you can see all the patches of red that blot our continents. Although only satellite sensors orbiting Earth can truly see these dots representing heat, we on Earth can see them as this.
That's right. Fires, or more specifically biomass burning, which is the burning of living or once living biological material that make up land ecosystems. How can there be so many points of active burning at any point in the day? Well, fires can burn anywhere with vegetation, whether it's the boreal forests of northern Eurasia, the grasslands of Africa, or the tropical rainforests of South America. The possible causes of biomass burning have expanded from just natural causes, like lightning, to include human-induced or anthropogenic causes, among many which are slash-and-burn techniques used by farmers to convert forests into farmland, and controlled fires, created by park rangers to maintain the health of certain ecosystems.
Now you're probably thinking, how do fires affect me? It doesn't matter if you're a squirrel in the boreal forest, a student on the west coast, or a penguin in the South Pole. Fires will affect you, because in addition to altering their immediate landscape, fires have several major emissions with global impacts. For example, biomass burning emits greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide that traps heat from the sun in the atmosphere and contributes to climate change. Fires also produce a substantial amount of pollutants like carbon monoxide, which can hurt lung tissue and is a precursor to ground-level ozone. Additionally, biomass burning produces aerosols, or airborne solid or liquid particles suspended in the air. Fires emit a unique aerosol called black carbon, or what we know as soot. Black carbon can change cloud properties, and by doing so, alter precipitation patterns. Because smoke can travel very long distances, soot from different parts of the world can end up landing on ice in the poles, blackening the ice, absorbing heat, and leading to an accelerated melt of snow and ice, which can accelerate sea level rise that can threaten coastal inhabitants. NASA scientists can use satellite instruments in space to detect strong heat from fires. Starting with the MODIS instrument launched aboard Terra in 1999 and later on Aqua in 2002, many NASA satellite sensors have been equipped with direct broadcast, which allows scientists to collect raw data and broadcast it immediately to any organization with the right equipment and software. This allows agencies across the world to receive fire detection information in near real time to enhance preparedness and early warning. Thanks to the smart usage of advanced satellite observations and computer modeling, scientists are better understanding and quantifying biomass burning, an important player in the future of our global environment and ecosystems.